Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we're doing a St. Patrick's Day theme. St. Patrick's Day is coming up on March 17th.
That's what we're gonna look around.
We're looking at St. Patrick's Day stuff.
And see what we get to come up with.
Yeah.
All right, we'll get back in soon.
Yeah, and we'll have some fun looking for more things.
Now, I actually did not find that many things from Party City. I think the only things I got there were the beads. Most of this stuff I got from the Dollar Tree and got it from Amazon. Here you see that we have garland and we have St. Patrick's Day wall cutout. We have some flowers and we have a porch sign for St. Patrick's Day and we have some fringe. Let's get started blowing up some balloons. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to use some beads and turn them into some beautiful decorations. So stay tuned for that. Let's get this curtain fringe background up. I like to put it up with tape because it makes it easier to take down for me to reuse later. This is a hanging porch sign. Oops, not sure what that was that fell out. But anyway, I decided to use it with the curtain fringe to just give it a different, unique look. And I'm just using tacks to hang it up on the wall. Now we're going to use some cloverleaf wall hangings and I'm just going to use some tacks and hang these on either side of the backdrop. Now I'm taking some balloons, I'm putting some tape on the tied ends and we're just going to put balloons across the top to kind of make a balloon border. So these are the cloverleaf cutouts that I got from the Dollar Tree. I'm just trying to figure out how I want to arrange them on the backdrop. And then I'm simply going to just take some tacks and I'm going to stick them up there to help me hold them up. So now I'm taking the beads that I got from Party City and I'm going to go ahead and cut this little part here that keeps them attached. I'm going to cut that off because I want them to hang loose. And then I'm trying to figure out how I want to hang them with the backdrop, so I'm going to use some tape. And then once I start pulling it, I see that I'm not liking the look with the beads. It wasn't working for me. So then I said, let's try the garland and see if we can make this work. And then I did like the look that the garland was giving me. So I stuck with that. I'm using tacks in addition to the tape to help secure the garland on the backdrop. And then I'm simply just kind of making a design, like almost like a curved zigzag around the cloverleaf cutouts. Just trying to make it like a little design. And I'm using tacks and tape to help me secure that around the backdrop. Okay friends, now this was a little banner that came with the porch signs and I'm going to use that next. I'm just using a tack to help me hang that up and then I'm cutting some more beads and then I found a better use for the beads to put them underneath the hanging clover leaves on the side of the backdrop. Now I'm just measuring them with the previous beads that I cut to try to get them about an equal size. And then I'm putting them up with some tape right here. And I decided to just make some hang a little bit lower and some to hang higher just to give it a little dimension to the look of the beads. And I'm doing the same thing to the other side. And right here I'm cutting the flowers. I'm using pliers to cut them off easily. And in just a few moments, you're gonna see how I'm gonna use these. Right now, I'm just adding a few more balloons to either side of the backdrop. Okay, and now it's time for the flowers. I'm going to tape them and place them behind the little banner sign that I got, and I'm using tacks to help hold the flowers in place. And then I'm just taking flowers and the little clover leaf and kind of just alternating them and just sticking them inside of the sign. And I did think of an alternative to use for the flowers. I'm sticking them inside the cluster of balloons I had on either side of the backdrop. And so what I just did is took a couple of them out from behind the sign and used them there. So I thought that would be cute as well. And here you have it, the final results for St. Patrick's Day. Thanks for watching. Make sure you hit that thumbs up, hit the subscribe button and notification bell. Make sure you check out my International Women's Day video from last week and have a royal day.